the ground starting to get to work. We are very engaged in supporting Romania and our allies in the Black Sea. So we really, you know, the rules-based international order started with the Transatlantic Alliance, and we have to first and foremost be sure that that alliance is strong, so we are really engaged. In terms of authoritarianism creeping into countries, you know, I think there are two things happening on the liberal democracy, you know, health watch in the world. One is this assumption we used to have, some people used to have, I probably had it also, because I'm an optimist, that as authoritarian regimes grew richer, they would sort of inevitably move towards being a liberal democracy. And, you know, people often talk about Francis Fukuyama's end of history, but this has been an idea from before that, right? Jean Kirkpatrick talked about it, and it happened in a lot of countries. So that seems not to be working, and we're seeing a lot of authoritarian regimes get richer and decide they want to stay authoritarian, which is worrying and makes this international order harder to maintain. But the second thing we're seeing is countries that had been really quite effectively moving towards being liberal democracies are pulling back. One issue that Canada is concerned about, that we've been public about, partly because Canadian students and professors are involved, is the attacks on Central European University. That was a really great, and here we are in a university, so maybe it's worth mentioning, a really fantastic institution. I think it's really sad for Hungary that it is having to move some of its operations to Vienna. And so we express our views, and we do what we can also. I think this is important as well, to shore up our liberal democratic allies. That's one reason that I think we're working so hard in the Baltics. It's one reason that last week we announced $24 million to support the election in Ukraine this spring, which will be absolutely crucial. And there will be, if invited, there will be a very big Canadian election monitoring mission. We will work to support the OSCE. And part of the work we will do is to try to help try to defend the integrity of that process against outside malign actors.
We're going to have to pause there. Jameson.
Please join me in thanking everyone who was on stage tonight.
Great.
So my name is Jameson Stevie. I'm the executive director of the Martin Prosperity Institute. A couple things in closing. First of all, it's important, I think, sometimes at these moments, we start off with a joke about the minister rolling up on a bike. But this is actually kind of remarkable, that we can have a minister of the crown freely traveling the streets without armed guards, come to an event where none of you got checked as you walked in the door, where journalists asked questions of a minister in an unprepared format, and then questions came from the floor. So when we worry about the state of institutions, we're doing okay. And to the New York Times journalists, all Canadians ask this level of question. We are an incredibly literate and bright people. So four things in conclusion. Number one, a story that is only known to about four or five people. Then Chrystia Freeland had two pieces of paper on her desk. One was a contract to become a fellow with the MPI, and the other were her nomination papers. Chrystia Freeland then called me and said, "What do you think?" And I said, "Well, have you signed the nomination papers?" She said, "Yes," and I said, "Then I think that's a great choice." She said, "Well, what's the worst that could happen? I lose?" And I said, no, the worst that could happen is you win. But on behalf of all Canadians, I'm sure as hell glad you did. All politics aside, knowing that a woman of your intelligence and your character goes into the room to reflect our interests is of great comfort to me and to many of us in the audience. So thank you for your public service. Secondly, to the New York Times and in front of the CEO, we have had nothing but wonderful relations with the New York Times since the day we started this partnership. And we thank you for your continued presence in Canada, your interest in Canada. We will continue to provide you with subscribership in Canada. And what I would say is, back to Minister Freeland's comment, your job has never been more important to hold those to account, because as the saying goes, first they killed all the journalists and no one else what happens next because no one was there to write the story. So make sure you keep it up. Thirdly, while there isn't a scum of Minister Freeland available for the press, she has to get back on her bike and head to her next event. Although in those shoes, it might be a tough slog. I know you can do it. I know you can do it. Sorry, I didn't mean to question. Mark will be available for questions for media in Classroom 151 just to the side. And then finally, it's kind of bittersweet. The MPI, this is something known to Minister Freeland, the MPI, which has been in existence for about 11 years, will be wrapping up its work this June. Roger Martin will be moving on to other pastures and as a professor emeritus here at the school, and Richard Florida will be moving on to the School of Cities. But that doesn't mean we're going anywhere too fast. We're going to keep up our good work for the next 6 months. We have events with Frank Fukuyama, with Jonathan Haidt, with Mariana Mazzucato, and we'll be coming with publications around the strength of democratic institutions. So continue to watch our space. Thank you. Get home safe.